Hey there, it's Markus, the man from Mars. I'm in the big city today, and sometimes a little change of scenery is exactly what the doctor ordered to keep me creative and focused. But I'm not here to talk about that today. Though, I had a thought. Being in the big city, there's so many people around, and I thought, there's not a single person nearby who knows everything that there is to know about anything. And there are lots of people who know a little bit about some things. But for us today, as aspiring musicians, as creative individuals who love and are passionate about music, my challenge is this. Do you know what you don't know? And do you see this as the great opportunity that it is? You see, not knowing things isn't a weakness. Being aware of it is, in fact, a strength. So we're going to talk. My name is Markus, the man from Mars. Thank you so much for joining me. I'd love to hear your comments. I appreciate your likes, and I would absolutely love it if you consider subscribing to this channel. Thanks so much, and let's get talking. So, not knowing something is an opportunity as long as we know what we don't know. I'm Markus, the man from Mars, and thanks so much for sticking around for this topic. See, it took me a very long time to realize, number one, what I don't know, and it's okay for people to know what I don't know. Why? Because it's an opportunity and an advantage. If I know what I don't know and then I'm willing to learn, wow, I'm ahead of the game already just by that realization. There's no point in pretending to know things that you don't actually know. But it's tempting, isn't it? Somebody says, hey, do you know what linear drumming is? You're like, sure, doesn't everybody? They teach that in preschool. Talking about recording techniques. Heck, sometimes people say, oh, you know this artist? And it's tempting to say, yeah, I think I heard a couple of their songs. No, why not say, I've never heard of that person. Tell me about them. I don't know what linear drumming is. No, I don't know a good substitute for a pop filter. No, I don't know the best, easiest way to play bar chords. No, I don't know everything there is to know about cello rosin. And then it's an opportunity to learn. See, one of the things that I've really noticed too, it's very dangerous. A lot of people aren't willing to say in music or otherwise what they don't know, but it doesn't prevent them from really sharing a lot of information that they might have heard, misheard, been told by somebody else who doesn't know. So it's very tricky. I believe one of the greatest ways that we can remain creative and growing and developing as musicians is to say, you know, I don't know, to be humble about it. But I could say, yeah, maybe I know a jazz chord or two, but I really don't know anything about performing jazz. Maybe I can look into it. Maybe when you're in a conversation with somebody who does, you'll begin to say, wow, okay, I'm learning. And in a few minutes, you'll learn more than you did in a lifetime of not knowing by knowing what you don't know. It's an opportunity to learn. One of my favorite stories, I was trying to learn the song Harlem Nocturne. It's a really cool song, and I was trying to learn the left-hand chords, and I just couldn't do it. And I'm trying to use all five fingers, and I'm just spreading it and making it so hard. And Rob Phillips, who's been a great friend and mentor piano-wise, and I love picking his brain about it, I said to him, Rob, how do you play these five-finger chords? I just can't get it. And he kind of looked at me funny, and I showed him the chords that I was trying to play, and he showed me a way to play those jazzy sounding chords, I wouldn't have believed it, with three fingers only. It was still quite a reach, but all of a sudden it wasn't a contortion anymore. And by being able to say, hey, I don't know this, by reaching out to someone who did know, I was suddenly able to do this. I don't know if you've ever been in a situation in a studio and you don't have a pop filter for the microphone and it's just like plosives going crazy. You know, actually, stop, wait. I'm the man from Mars of the future. I've got the power of hindsight. I've got a better story for later instead of this one. And I think music is so great and so rewarding. Isn't it exciting? You think about it, knowing what you don't know is the opportunity to add to your knowledge base. Think of the excitement when you first learned something a while back. Remember how great that felt in music when you added on to your knowledge base? Let's not allow ourselves to get stuck in a rut where we have to pretend that we know things that we don't know to try to impress or placate other people who don't know what they don't know. The final thought I wanted to add this morning is know what you don't know, but again, a piece of paper. But be willing to share what you do. See, if we just don't know things and all we have is Google and forums with people we don't know telling us things that they might not know. See, to me, with music, there's no substitute with connecting with real people. So one of these things that we try to cultivate as Maar Music is not only being a pretty awesome music store, but frankly, one of the things we're passionate about is connecting people, connecting musicians, being a hub for the arts and culture that are accessible and welcoming to everybody in the community. I love sharing knowledge. And knowing what you don't know is an opportunity to learn, but I'm encouraging everyone, please, the things that you really do know, consider sharing them. Mentorship, helping other people, that's another opportunity for growth. It's another opportunity for satisfaction in music and life. I love sharing the things that I know, and there's nothing almost quite as rewarding as seeing people grow in their own knowledge and their development of music because of me passing on the things that I know. But I wouldn't know the things that I do if countless generations before hadn't passed it on to me. The better story is one that happened in between the time that I posted the last video and that I was editing this video. My friend Paul Clark gave me a wonderfully encouraging message about the content of the first episode, but he kindly suggested, based on his experience as a videographer, how to better frame the shot to make the videos more watchable. So thank you so much for sharing what you know that I don't know. So if the framing of the videos isn't so good, it's not because I don't know better. Thanks again. And you know, it's cool sometimes if it's over the internet and we have a great resource, but there is no substitute for connecting with people of different ages, different backgrounds, different cultures, different music styles, whatever it is. You know, just have a conversation and wow, knowing what you don't know is a fantastic opportunity for growth, for development, for enjoying music and life. I'm Markus, the man from Mars. Please let me know what you think. And also, please, if you have anything really cool or interesting to share, or if you have a question, reach out, whether you comment here or in the store and in person, email through our website. I'm always happy to hear from everybody. Thank you again. Again, I couldn't and I wouldn't do it without you. Please don't forget to like if you like this, comment, and I would love it if you subscribed. Thank you so much. I'm Markus, the man from Mars.